Let's talk about the XYZ coordinate system. So first, let's just see what it looks like. So here I have a three-dimensional coordinate plane. And I've kind of tried to align this so that X and Y are kind of in the position you're already familiar with. The X axis is in red here, and then the Y axis is in green. But then what's new is this Z axis. Okay, so the important thing here is that the z-axis goes through the origin of the xy plane, and it's perpendicular to both the x and the y axis. So just like with the x and the y axes, it's important to know which direction is positive and which direction is negative. So with the z-axis, this new z-axis, we need some sort of convention that's going to tell us what's the positive direction. So often what people do is something called the right-hand rule, or I think in the book it's called the right-handed coordinate system. Maybe this is something you remember from physics class. So basically this is a way to tell you where the positive z-axis points. So the way you do this is you take your right hand and you curl your fingers in the direction from the positive x-axis to the positive y-axis, okay, and if you curl your fingers in that direction, your thumb should point in the direction of the positive z-axis. So let me show you this from another perspective. So when you draw on your paper, you of course are drawing in two dimensions, so let's say you draw your x-y-axis in the standard location here. So in this case, if we were to do the right-hand rule to determine the direction the positive z-axis is facing, we would take our right hand, we would curl our fingers in the direction from the positive x-axis from the positive y-axis. Okay, so you're kind of curling your fingers in this direction, and your thumb then should be pointing out of the page toward you. Okay, so then what you can do is you can visualize that in this orientation, the positive z-axis would be coming straight perpendicular out of the page towards you. So the three-dimensional coordinate system, or the XYZ coordinate system, can be subdivided into three planes. So let's take a minute and look at those. Now the first one we'll talk about is the XY plane. That's what you're already familiar with. So that's what's shown in blue in this picture. This is the XY plane. Okay, so once again, this is what you're already familiar with. This is what you usually draw on your paper. And the XY plane is simply the plane that has a Z value of 0 for all points. Okay, so the XY plane can be written as Z equals 0, and it's just a set of points with any xy value, but with a z value of 0. All right, now here I have the yz plane. Okay, so the yz plane consists of all the points where x is 0, right, and then I have this plane that stretches in the y and the z directions. Okay, so we're talking about the yz plane, and if I wanted to write an equation for this plane, I'd write x equals 0, okay, because this is defined by all the points that have an x value of 0. So x has to be 0, but y and z can be any value, and that's the yz plane. And then finally, we have the xz plane. Okay, so here y is 0. Okay, so this is the plane defined by a y value of 0, and then you'll notice we have points, the other points, x and z, can be any value. Okay, so once again, this is the xz plane. If I were to write an equation for this, I'd write y equals 0, and as far as points go, x and z can be anything, but y has to be 0.